When peace like a river attendeth my way.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We're gathered here to celebrate the life of our dear brother and friend, grandfather, husband. We regret the passing of our dear friend, but as life goes on, the Lord says he give and he take it away. And so today, we are here to celebrate the life of Reginald de Costa Palmer, otherwise known as Mas Reggie. And so the program will flow as you know, as you have it recorded. And so our opening hymn, Amazing Grace. And so we'll all join in singing this beautiful hymn. I invite you now to bow your heads as we pray. Our Father and our God, the one who is the creator and sustainer of all things, give you thanks, Lord, for the life that you have lent to our dear brother. And as we gather for this program, we ask that you will direct the proceedings. Be with all of us and may the program be a means of bringing us even closer to you. And so, Lord, we ask that you will take full charge. And in the end, may your name be glorified. Bless all who have gathered to celebrate and to join with us in this program. May your blessing be with them. We ask these in your precious name. Amen. Amen. Our first lesson will be done by Nicole Solomon, the great-granddaughter of the deceased.
Our first lesson is taken from the book of Psalms, chapter 90, verses 1 to 12. And it reads, Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thou turnest man to destruction, and sayest, Return, ye children of men. For 1,000 years in thy sight are as yesterday when it is past, and as a watch in the night. Thou carriest them away with a flood. They are as asleep in the morning, they are like grass which groweth up. In the morning it flourisheth and groweth up. In the evening it is cut down and withereth. For we are consumed by thine anger, and by thy wrath we are troubled. Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our secret sins in the light of thy countenance. For all our days are passed away in thy wrath. We spend our years as a tale that is told. The days of our years are 80 years. And if by reason of strength they be 80 years, yet it is their strength, labor, and sorrow, for it is soon cut off, and we fly away. Who knoweth the power of thine anger? Even according to thy fear, so is thy wrath. 12 and last, so teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Special music will be done for us by Mr. Dave Gale, nephew-in-law, after which we'll have the second lesson by Jonoy Palmer, grandson.
The timeless theme, earth and heaven, will pass away. It's not a dream. God will make all things new. That day, gone is the curse from which we stumble and fell. Evil is banished to eternal hell. No more nights, no more pain, no more tears, no more crying again. Praises to the great I am, and we will live in the light of the risen Lamb. See all around, all the nations bow down to see. The only sound are the praises to Christ, O King. Slowly the names of the book are read. I know the King, so there's no need to dread. there'll be no crying again. Praise says to that great I am, and we will live, fear the light of the risen Lamb. You see, over there is a mansion prepared for me, where I will live with my Savior eternally. And there will be no more night. There'll be no more pain, no more tears. There'll be no crying again.
Scripture reading for today will be taken from Revelations 21, reading from verses 1 to 7. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice of heaven say, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and I will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, either shall there be any more pain. For the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne shall behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said unto me, it is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcome shall inherit all things, and I will be the God, and he shall be my son. This is the reading of God's holy word.
The program continues, and we have our remembrance will be done for us by Janice Palmer, daughter. After which, we'll ask Donnet Fagan, daughter, and Crystal Palmer Rowe, granddaughter, to give for us the tributes.
Our father, Master Reggie, was indeed a very strict and hard-working person. He ensured that his family was always comfortable in a place they could call their home. he would form by Bethlehem College. Every evening, you could see him carrying something on his head to put into the pot. He was very responsible. He would say, "If I win, sir, I'm here the man for the yard." My dad visited his friends at Southfield and bring their foods and vegetables. He was a good climber, picking apples, ackee, and nilsberry. Whenever my sisters are coming from Mandeville or USA, he would always ensure they got their goodies. My father was very kind, loving. Every lady, he would call them me woman. His favorite game was domino and ludi. Dad, we love you. Thank you for everything you do for us. We appreciate it. We love you, but Jesus loves you most. Sleep on and take your rest.
Once again, I woke up to be greeted by a living nightmare called reality. What moved through us in silent and quiet sadness, longing for one more day, one more word. We may not understand why you left this earth so soon, or why you left before we were ready to say goodbye. But little by little, we begin to remember not just that you die, but that you live, and that your life gave us memories too beautiful to forget. Losing Master Reggie is one of the most difficult things I have gone through. I am standing up here today. I have realized how fortunate I was to have him as a father. There are not enough words to express his influence in my life. It is through his example that I learned to be the woman I am today. Master Reggie was hardworking, strong, loving, and gentle in his own word, in his own way. He loved his family and was deeply devoted to my mother and her children. However, he was no saint by any means or stretch of the imagination. I remember one day I asked my mother, "Why Master Reggie worked so much?" She looked at me and said, "My child," I asked him the same question. "He worked a lot." I did not realize then, but that was one of the biggest lessons I learned from him, the value of hard work. Master Reggie woke up every day, early in the morning to get to the farm to provide for his family. I could count on one hand how many times Master Reggie was sick. Even if he did not feel well, he will get up and go to work, of course. He truly believed that if you work hard, you could have a good life. I will surely miss his peanut grater cake, drops, potato pudding, corn pudding, and bami. Little did I know that it was the last time of March of this year. Although he was not feeling well, he made sure that my grater cake was done properly to send to me in America. Although Master Reggie have never said it out loud, I know that he was truly proud of his children. I don't know how long it will take me to grieve this tremendous loss. Gone, but not forgotten. Rest in peace, Master Reggie.
Life is just a stepping stone, a pause before we make it home. A simple place to rest and to be until we reach eternity. Everyone has a life journey, a path to take with lots to see. God guides our steps along the way, but we were never meant to stay. Our final destination is a place filled with love, His majesty and grace. Today, we celebrate the life of a loved one who has gone before us, the race he has won, His journey has now ended. His spirit has ascended, claiming the great rewards with Jesus our Lord. Rest in peace, Grandpa.
The eulogy for this service will be done by two beautiful ladies, Sharon and Joyce Fagan, the daughters of the deceased.
Eulogy of the life of Reginald de Costa Palmer, otherwise known as Mass Reggie or Beagle. Reginald de Costa Palmer, affectionately called Mass Reggie, as Beagle to those who grew up with him, and as a king to those who played domino with him. He saw the light of day on April 6, 1939, when he was born as the fifth child and the fifth son of the late Berita and Hubert Palmer in Kenole, Malvern, St. Elizabeth. He was enrolled at the Bethlehem Elementary School in 1943. At a tender age, he demonstrated a habit of independence and hard-working attitude. This he carried into his manhood, and although of limited educational achievement, he was successful in earning a livelihood for himself and later his wife and children.
He was not academically inclined, but you could fool him with numbers. Many who did business with him at his farm or shop could testify of this. His passion could be seen in his early love for farming and animal rearing. He was not one who would call a humble child, as he was often trying to show that he was the strongest and the best at everything he did. He began his journey into adulthood by planting his own crops and working for others in construction, agriculture, and at Denzel James's Bakery in Hampton. Master Reggie was very talented in many things, baking, cooking, construction, to name a few. He was mainly a shopkeeper with farming as his true calling. The Bible says, "In the morning sow thy seed, and in the evening withhold not thine hand, for thou knowest not whether shall prosper, either this or that, or whether they both shall be alike good."
Proverbs 20, verse 4 also tells us that those who are too lazy to plow in the right season will have no food at the harvest. Master Reggie was eager to amass additional funds. Hence, he sought employment on the Overseas Farm Work Program for the first time in 1966. As children, we remembered stories of how he would hide a few American apples in his luggage so we could taste them. It was not like now, when American apples are widely available in Jamaica. He would also be certain to bring back something for all of us, even ribbons and panties that most men back then were reluctant to purchase publicly.
A few years ago, he handed over the shopkeeping business to his daughter Janice and continued with the farming. With a wife for over 53 years, by his side, as equally as hardworking and ambitious, he was able to prosper and increase his financial independence by building a shop mostly with his own hands. He supplied farm produce to the college and buyers in his field. He often gave away almost more than he sold. Through his kindness, many people in the community, students and teachers of the Bethlehem College, were able to have ground provisions to eat and would remember his kindness even years after graduating.
He was able to adequately provide for his children and finance some with college education. With the income from his farm beside Bethlehem Teachers College, his shop, traveling overseas on the farm work program, and animal rearing. Special mention must be made of his brother Asman, who helped him on the farm for many years. Many said he was his favorite brother. Mas Reggie grew up in the church and would have benefited from his early Christian teachings from Mother Edwards and Reverend Levy from the Mount Olive Baptist Church. In his later years, he attended the Bethlehem Moravian Church, the place that was so central to where he spent most of his working days and met lifetime friends. He often said his success was due to the blessing from God and having a wife he could rely on to run the house and make things stretch. His blessings enabled him to purchase other properties, expand the shop, and build another house for renting. He would be one of the first to tell you that he did not have a lot of cash, but he not take chicken to buy him out easy.
Master Reggie was often seen as a strong, hard man and disciplinarian. As children, we had to attend church, and he was not in support of smoking, drinking alcoholic beverages, partying, or letting the sun catch children in bed. Every child that grew with him, even grandchildren, had to be able to do things in the yard and help out on the farm during planting and reaping time. However, he would never sell everything and not share a little pocket money with each of us.
Even though he appeared serious to some on the outside, he was a joker and a trickster. He was an expert at moving silently and often frightening people with his animal sounds. And he always loved to move his waistline and strike a pose to show you how fit and strong he was. Even just before his brief illness, he would still climb the coconut, aki, apple, and mango tree, and even work on his beloved farm from before sun up until in the afternoon. His farm was not only his main livelihood, but a source of pride and joy. He would carry many people to his farm and show his hard work and great care he put into it to make it picture perfect. He was very proud of his farming skill, and only his pride in his children and grandchildren could compete. He was a man that would often boast about how well they were doing and how God had blessed him. He never failed to give back to God, as every church harvest, he would find something from the farm to contribute to both the Mount Olive Baptist and Bethlehem Moravian churches. Many harvest goers would especially look out for his yam, sugar cane, and grater cakes.
Family and friends alike knew that the only other place where Master Reggie spent a lot of time every day was at his shop. The shop was not only for making money, but it was for his favorite hobby of playing dominoes. He was one of the best and most clever domino player. You were most likely to get a six love, especially if he was shuffling the game. His grandson, Trace, was one of the persons who loved to play domino with him, and you could almost bet your last dollar that they would be playing dominoes for most of the time when he would visit.
Master Reggie's kindness was known throughout Jamaica, and especially his home parish of St. Elizabeth. His name was fame, was most popular from Southfield to Santa Cruz. He was always carrying something to give away to his friends and even strangers. There was no other like Master Reggie. to the many students, teachers, business people, especially in Santa Cruz, where he bought goods for his shop, farmers and fishermen in the vicinity of Southfield, Treasure Beach, and Alligator Pond would often partake in the barter system, that is yam for fish. No matter how you visit his house, he would not let you leave without giving you something, even if you had to wait a while for him to go to the farm to get it.
He was a man who spoke his mind, so some might not have liked him straightforward nature. But you could not call him a hypocrite. Possibly for every 10 persons, one criticized him. There would be 100 who would praise him for his kindness and hard work. He was a farmer to the very end. On his last night, March 26, 2021, there was an earlier disagreement over when would the best time to plant the red peas at his farm. At about 8:30 p.m., on his way to the bathroom, he said to his wife, Pearl, "You vex with me over the peas?" She replied, "Richie, how me fi vex with you and it's your peas?" He said, "Oh, okay, good." Perhaps he didn't feel well and was heading to the bathroom, but he paused to say that to his wife. On his way back to the bedroom, he stumbled on the floor, and Mama rushed to assist him with some smelling salt to inhale. Shortly after, he got up on his own and went to sit in the living room sofa. His last words to his wife after sitting down quietly was, "Pearl, call the parlor." So a man who had lived at his life, showing great strength, energy, hard work, powerful both in spirit and in voice, passed away peacefully. No fuss, no fight, but a quiet acceptance that he had run his race of life and maintained his independence to the last breath.
We are here today to remember the life and legacy he leaves on the earth. It was a long and simple life, never complex, and always with good, honest intention. Family man is a term not appreciated nearly enough these days. Today, there is more emphasis put on who we are and what we accomplish. He never asked for much. He never took anything in life for granted, but he was determined and ambitious. After all, you do not become one of the most successful farmers by luck. Just like going home for holidays, Mama would mostly be in the kitchen and he would be somewhere in the shed sorting or storing some ground provisions. They had a life together that was inspirational. Sure, through the years, there were issues they had to work through. However, no matter the issue, they made the most of their life together. Some says it is what you leave on this earth that shows what you did with your life.
What Master Reggie was able to show that it was more important to grow old with style and dignity and give everything you can do to people you love. Through his brief illness, he thanked Mama for all she did and told her that when the time come, he would prefer to be buried right here at Bethlehem. Some people leave this earth without their names being immortalized in history books, but that does not mean that they were forgotten. They are remembered by their friends and family, and some special people are remembered by people they hardly knew. Master Reggie was one of those persons. And though he wasn't a rich man, He provided his family with a roof over their heads and always food on the table, and many other tables of people he freely gave his fruit of his labor to, as he did for his own family.
We cannot, Lord, thy purpose see, but all is well that is done by thee. He leaves to mourn wife Pearl,
9 children,
6 brothers,
1 sister,
18 grandchildren,
17 great-grandchildren,
and 3 great-grandchildren,
sisters-in-law,
brothers-in-law,
son and daughters-in-law,
grandson-in-law,
cousins,
nieces,
nephews,
and other relatives and friends. Sleep on, Beagle. Sleep on and take your rest. He will forever be in our hearts, and his memories will always live on. May his soul rest in peace. See you in the morning.
Heights by great men all remind us we must make our life sublime, and in parting leave behind us footprints in the sands of time. Master Reggie will always be remembered. His works have left indelible impressions in the heart of so many persons. Special music comes to us from Glenda Anderson, family friend, and the acknowledgement by Trace Solomon, grandson.
Dark midnight was my The family of the late Reginald Palmer would like to express profound thanks and appreciation to the numerous relatives, friends, and well-wishers who have supported us through prayers, cards, telephone calls, emails, WhatsApp messages, and other expressions of love and kindness during our time of bereavement. Special thanks to Dwayne Mills, USA, Mr. Irvin Blake, England, the Fagan family, New Jersey, USA, Sandra, Lorna, and Michelle, USA, Mr. Winston Blake, Florida, USA, the Northern Caribbean University Academic Administration Department, Bethlehem Moravian College, Reverend McLean of Bethlehem Moravian College, and all those others who supported nightly and during our time of sadness. We are sincerely grateful to everyone for giving us support and comfort during our loss and time of sadness. We are much appreciated, and we thank you all. And we, as a family, will go forward knowing that we have the support of those who care for us and will sustain us during this and other difficult times.
We'll now move to the Bethlehem Moravian Cemetery for the interment.
When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea